Nancy's Adirondack Art presents Posey and How She Became Queen, written and sculpted by Nancy McGrath.
Queen Posey and Prince Poppy live in the Pearl Palace amidst much luxury. Their table is laid with all their favorite food, corn on the cob, wild marigold honey, strawberry cake, the finest green tea, and of course, the most delicious cheese in the county. The queen has a beautiful crown and robe that she wears for all royal occasions. Of course, the prince wears his royal helmet. The castle is beautifully furnished and has a chandelier upstairs in the bedroom and a lightning bug lantern for the parlor. The palace sits in a wonderful ivy vine with roses growing all around, and they are very happy and content. However, it hasn't always been so. Posey and Poppy grew up, got married, and raised four children under the shadow of the great owl. He ruled over the forest where Posey and Poppy lived. It was very scary and hard to get about, knowing that the owl menace was always over them. But they lived their lives, worked hard, and brought up their four children. Eventually, the children went off to begin their own lives, and Posey and Poppy were left by themselves. Over tea one evening, Posey said to Poppy, "I'm worried." Poppy looked at her and said, "I am too. I know our children are very clever, but we are no longer there to help. I hope they remember all we've taught them." "Oh, I'm sure they will. I just wish we could rid our forest of the owl for good." Poppy nodded. "I think we should try," Posey said. "What? What could we possibly do?" Poppy stammered. "Let me think about it," Posey pondered. The next day she said, "I think I have a plan." A few days later they were ready and ventured into an area where they knew the owl would see them. No sooner had they stepped out than the owl swooped down and picked them up. With Posey in one talon and Poppy in the other, the owl took them to his nest high in the old oak tree. Now, we know that owls eat mice, but thankfully the owl was not particularly hungry just now and thought he'd save these mice for supper later that evening. Poppy was nervous and slightly distraught, as one would imagine, but Posey concentrated on her plan. You see, Posey had learned a thing or two at home with their four children. What she had learned was that she could always solve a problem by telling a good story. Her stories never failed to make a rainy day brighter, a boo-boo knee feel better, or work go by faster. So she counted on her story now. When they were in the owl's nest high in the oak tree, Posey stood up on shaky legs. Poppy stood next to her for support. "Mr. Owl," she began rather shyly.
"Yes," he boomed in reply.
That startled her, but she continued. "Poppy and I were sent to find you. We never dreamed it would be this easy." "Now why would you want to find me?" he replied with a leer. "We come from a very large kingdom of mice, where we have heard of the wise owl, but have never seen one. We have many, many mice in our kingdom, but they are rather unruly, and we thought if we had a wise owl, he could bring peace and order to our kingdom, and all would be well." With that, the owl's eyes opened ever so wide. He stood and fluffed his wings and said, "I would be honored to be your owl," as he looked down his beak at them. "Pray tell, how does one reach your kingdom?" Posey put a paw up to cover her smile. "We are so honored, wise owl. Follow the sun to the west and keep going until you reach it. The kingdom will be there." Without giving another thought to Posey and Poppy, the owl spread his wings, turned his face to the sun, and flew off. He was never seen in those parts again. After a little while, the two mice caught their breath and gingerly made their way down the big oak tree. When they reached the ground, they were greeted by dozens of mice and other small woodland creatures that were cheering and applauding. Shouts of, "How'd you do it?" and "What could have happened?" met their ears. So Posey told them the story she had made up and what the owl did. They all laughed with relief. Well, all the animals were so grateful to be rid of the awful and scary owl that they made Posey their queen for her wisdom and bravery. They built Posey and Poppy a beautiful pearl palace among the vines, where they live quite happily to this day.